In the epistle today, St. Peter tells us, the ancients who are among you, I beseech to feed the flock of God, taking care of it. And you young men, that you should be subject to the ancients, and do everything to insinuate humility one to another. For God resisteth the proud, but to the humble he giveth grace. Be you humbled, therefore, under the mighty hand of God. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. Today is the feast of St. Apollinaris, boys, and you see by the red vestment that he was a martyr. St. Peter, the prince of the apostles, sent him from Rome over to the other side of Italy, where the Adriatic Sea is, to a city named Ravenna. And there he worked very hard and very long to spread the true Catholic faith. There he suffered a kind of a martyrdom that lasted 28 years. He was made to do sometimes terrible things, instead of just being beaten up and thrown into prison. Sometimes they tried to drown him. Sometimes he was made to walk over red-hot coals. And all of these things, he survived so that he could nourish and build up God's church there. But what is interesting about our saint, though, most of all, is that long after he was dead, somebody got the idea, because the emperor was living in that city of Ravenna and not in Rome anymore, that the bishop and the priests in that city wouldn't have to obey the Pope, and they could do whatever they wanted to. And the Pope would just have to sort of mind his own business and not tell them what to do, which, of course, you know, would be very non-Catholic and very proud. And so the Church wrote a beautiful mass that Father Saavedra has just now read at the altar for this feast day. And throughout the mass, we're reminded, be humble. Don't think that you're better than everybody else. Remember that you're a Catholic, and to be a Catholic means you must obey. Now, to go from the sublime to the ridiculous, in a sense, to the boys, when our sermon's over, and you've made your genuflection, and be sure to thank our Lord for the graces he's given you this morning by this Mass and this Holy Communion, while you go into the hall to have some breakfast. And what will you see waiting for you, aside from the nice little pre-prepared sugary boxes of cereal? There's some bananas that are out there. I noticed the bananas the other night when they set the table for the first breakfast. Bananas. Why do you think the bananas are there? Well, Father Saavedra loves bananas. In fact, as part of his ration, every week when he comes to teach here, we have to give him two bananas, and that seems to last him for several days, and he's quite happy with them. Usually, children these days, though, don't go so much for eating fruit, which is a shame. You would go towards packaged food and sugar and things like that. But even animals know that bananas and other fresh fruits are very good for us to eat. Of course, we associate bananas with monkeys. And I'm bringing this up because I have a monkey tale to tell you about this morning. It seems that there were two monkeys, and one was named Jumbo and one was named Sambo. And they were walking along in the jungle in Africa, just doing what monkeys usually do, when they spied across a river with a very strong current. They spied a tree that was lush and hanging with an abundance of bananas. Now, what would they do to be able to get at the bananas? One of the monkeys, named Jumbo, why, he was a very tall monkey. And he could swim. He was very strong. The other monkey was about half his size, his name was Sambo, but he couldn't swim at all, but he could climb a tree. So, as animals do sometimes, just by using the instinct which God gave them, remarkable, sometimes animals can even use a sort of a very primitive kind of tool to get their food. They cooperated with each other, and they realized that by themselves, they'd never get their breakfast of bananas. But if they worked together, they would. And so Jumbo swam across the river with Sambo on his back. And when they got to the riverbank, to the tree, Sambo clambered up the tree, and he grabbed all the bananas, and they had themselves a feast. They worked together. Boys, to be able to work together amongst ourselves, under our parents, under father's direction, under your teacher, or any other elder or senior, as St. Peter says in today's epistle, who's in charge of you, why, that is an important example of humility. Now, if those monkeys, in a sense, it's just a story, but I mean, if those monkeys hadn't been humble enough to work together, if one thought, I can do it by myself, they would never have succeeded in getting their bananas to eat. They would have gone hungry. But because they worked together. Now, from the ridiculous to the sublime, the Blessed Mother, our Lord, all of the saints, they're all humble. If they're told to do something, they're very willing to do it. Our Lord himself went down to Nazareth, and he was obedient to his mother and to Saint Joseph. Unless somebody is showing you what to do when you're growing up, children, you won't be able to get too far, will you? I mean, could you imagine if you were just given an arithmetic book and say, here's the book, just do your lessons. Or if someone were to show you a piano and say, well, here's the piano, you just go ahead and learn it yourself. You wouldn't be able to. You have to have teachers, don't you? The teachers show you step by step how it works. You boys are old enough now to smile, maybe at a younger brother or sister, who, when they get to a certain age, maybe around 2 or 3 maybe, then they want to do everything themselves. They don't want anyone to do things for them. But even though they don't know quite how to do it yet, they're being a little bit proud and a little bit independent. Well, they have to be shown. You have to be shown. We all have to be shown. When we allow ourselves to be shown, and when later on we work together, we're being humble. And all sorts of wonderful things, real food, not just for the body or the mind, but even food for the soul, all of that comes with the grace of listening, doing what we are told, cooperating, and working with others. There are many people in the world today, children, who think to themselves, well, I can get to heaven by myself. I don't need the Catholic Church to tell me what to do. Oh, I can say my own prayers, and I don't need to go to Mass on Sunday to receive Holy Communion. Why, I can talk to God in the forest. I can talk to God on the golf course. I can talk to God when I'm in bed sleeping. That's what people say, and that's pretty silly, isn't it? Even monkeys would probably know better than that. But we make ourselves worse than the animal children, worse than the monkeys, because we think we can do it by ourselves, and they realize they have to cooperate together, and so must we. Our Lord gives us the means, but he wants us to be humble enough to use them, and if we don't, we will never, ever get there. It's always the same story, boys. It's always the devil who's whispering in your ear, don't listen, or you can do that on your own. Do it by yourself. Follow your own ideas. That's all just the devil, and that's all just pride. Had the monkeys been that way, they would never have gotten their bananas. And if we're that way, we'll never get any food or nourishment for our souls unto everlasting life. Today would be a good day, especially because we're at camp. And at camp, we have the father, and then we have the counselors to tell us what to do, just as at home. We have our parents, or during the school year, we have our teachers. And always we have father. The pastor or our priest. It's a good day to be thinking about being humble. When you're playing a game today, for example, boys, don't always insist on having your own way. Be a little bit more humble. Like, or let somebody else take a turn. Let somebody else go first. When you're told to do something, be obedient. Don't think to yourself, I know better. Don't make a face and don't grumble. Be humble. Our Lord was told what to do, and our Lord made us all. But he gave us the example of humility. When someone does correct you, boy, remember two things. Take it with a smile. Don't frown and show you're unhappy. And always say, thank you to the person. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Mr. or Mrs. Johnson, whatever the name is. Respectfully. Always say that. Always be humble in that sense, in your language. Oh, and don't forget to be courteous. A proud boy is someone who thinks you don't need anybody else, and I have it coming to me, I deserve it. We don't. A lot of people work very hard, boys, for you. So that you could have a wonderful experience like this camp. So that you can grow up in a Catholic family, in a Catholic church, and have the Holy Mass and save your soul. Always be humble enough to say, please, and excuse me, and thank you. Oh, and don't forget, magic words that even some adults forget to say, I'm sorry. If you remember just those little phrases, you'll do pretty well in life, boys, because you'll always be humble. Most of all, remember this. If we're humble, that means that we are willing to receive God's help through others and help others in order to carry out God's holy will. Remember, if those two monkeys hadn't been smart enough to work together, they would never have gotten their breakfast. Well, it's time for your breakfast now, and I hope that you have a good one. Don't forget to eat some fruit sometimes when it's offered to you. That's very good for your body, very good for your stomach, and your build strong bones 12 ways. But don't forget, too, the virtue of humility. Let's work together today in our camp day, and let's be humble enough to realize that we can't do it by ourselves. God bless you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen.